Fred plays what would be the whole song and then repeats the B.
Yeah.
The B is kind of short, but
right.
That's what we could call the B part. Big, the next one's small, and it, so it doesn't lay down a groove, because a groove thrives, groove is fed by repetition. You know, you hear something going over and over again, and it makes your body start moving to it. And if you're playing, you're wanting to make things repetitive. And so, what I'm saying about making your playing even is that when all those notes are going baka, 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 at the same intensity, the same tone, the same exact spot, it makes a groove. When the tone varies, when the intensity varies, it can still be musical, but it could be on top of a groove, or it still could be groovy. But when you're really repetitive, you're heading straight for the groove. There's a small difference between a groove and a rut. You know, because it's just a rut that you like, is what a groove is.
I like that.
I think the difference is that when you're in a rut, you want to get out of it. You're bored. When you're in a groove, you don't want to get out of it, and you're never bored. The groove is just absolutely the opposite of boredom. It's like right here, just with it. And a rut is like you've been doing something that you're tired of doing, and you don't want to be doing it, but you got to keep doing it. It could be the same thing for different people, you know. It has to do with your attitude. So that's why I'm always trying to get people to not be too creative, just be very repetitive. Because, I'm trying to be creative. It's like It's like handwriting. I mean, very few of us have tried to make our handwriting.